Hello everybody, welcome to the next lecture on the subject optimization technique. Today we will discuss about how to construct the simplest table with some arbitrary BFS. So myself Dr. Garg, I'm working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute. You can contact me by either of email IDs. So what is the main task of this today's presentation is, suppose you have this LPP. So then if someone asks you that solve this LPP by any of the methods. So then, since these are more than the two variables, you have to solve it with the help of the simplex method. So once you start with the simplex method, then you have to write in the standard form, and definitely you have starting BFS is S1, S2, S3, and so on. Okay, then you can find the entering variable and then leaving variable, and so on. But now in this task, we will see how to formulate the simplex table by taking instead of the S1, S2, S3 as a starting variable. We consider x2, x3, x1 as the starting BFS, or any others are there, any other combinations. For example, you can consider x1, x3 of S2, and so on. So that is, your task is to write directly this table instead of finding this and then finding the all. So the simple rule is B inverse of AJ. You can find the, that is, what is the AJ is, if you find the value of this, what is the meaning is B inverse A1. A1 is a column corresponding to X1. Similarly, for the second column, you can find the B inverse A2. The A2 is the column corresponding to the X2. For example, here, what is the A1? In this example is, what is the column corresponding to X1 is 203. Okay. Similarly, what is the column corresponding to X2 is, column corresponding to X3, column corresponding to S1, S2, S3, column corresponding to the right hand side. This is there. So the only task is to find the value of B inverse. So that's the task of this presentation. So we will discuss about the three different examples to solve them. So quickly look at the first example. So for the given LPP here, construct the simplex table by taking this as the starting BFS instead of starting with the original S1, S2 or A2, whatever. Then once you construct the simplex table, check whether this is the optimal or not. And if it is not optimal, then find your optimal solution. So what we do is, the first step is always be, you have to write in terms of the standard form. So the standard form is here. Now since look at that, this constant is greater than sign. So you have, and the third constant is equality. So I have to use the big M method here. Now it is given that S1, look at that, what is the starting point is, S1, X1 and X2 as your starting point. So what's my task is that, your task is to construct this table. The target of the problem is here. So it's very easy, just carefully watch the next 2-3 minutes, you will understand very carefully, easily. So what we do, this always form a B. These are basic, and my task is to find only B inverse. Okay, now look at that. Since this is a basic element, so what is the column corresponding to this is always I. So it, you have to task to find these 7 columns. So the first column is there, S1 100, X1 010, X2 here. Fine. So it means you have to need only these 4 columns. And ZJ minus CJ corresponding to these basic variables are always 0. So what is the remaining? So you have to left only 4 columns. So this one. Okay, now think about this. So what is the starting BFS? It is given to you that this and this as the starting BFS. So write the matrix B. The first column is x1 s1, second is x2, third is x1 and x2. So these are the values corresponding to the standard form. What is the standard form of the s1? Column corresponding to s1 is 100. So look at that. X1, what is the column corresponding to X1 is 231. So 231. Column corresponding to X2 is here 122. Okay. Now, based on this B, you can find the simply B inverse. Okay. Now, there are the two methods to find the column corresponding to these four. The first method is, you can find the B inverse of S2. So multiply with the column corresponding to S2. Similarly, for here, you can find the B inverse column corresponding to the A2 in the standard form, and so on. Apart from this, another simplest method is, look at that, who makes the I. If you start with this simplex method, from where you start? So you can start S1, A2, and A3. Okay, this is your starting BFS. So this is the column corresponding to S1. This is the column corresponding to A2. This is the column corresponding to A3. So you can substitute the value here. So S1 is here. A2 minus 3 by 4, 1 by 2, minus 1 by 4. And so on. So look at that. How many columns are pending? Only 2 columns are left. Okay. Also, you can see that, as we have discussed so many times in the previous video, what is the relation between S2 and A2? So the relation between S2 and A2 are, they are just opposite signs. So we know the S2 value. So what is the we know the A2 value. What is the S2? Just multiply with the negative sign. Okay. So what is the remaining? You have to find only the one column. Okay. So what we do is, you have to write this. So either you can write S2 in terms of negative of the A2, because S2 and A2 are opposite to each other. Else, you can find the column corresponding to S2 and column corresponding to the right hand side in terms of B inverse of, what is the column corresponding to S2? 0, minus 1, 0. Okay. Column corresponding to right hand side is 18, 30 and 26. So once you solve this problem, so B inverse is this. If you multiply the value of this, you will get this and this. So substitute value column corresponding to this as here. Again, look at that. This is just the opposite of each other. So this is the value. Okay. So what is the remaining is, you have to find the value of ZJ minus CJ. So how you find the ZJ minus CJ? That's quite easy, because what is the X1 is my 2. This is 4. Look at the objective function. S1 is 0. This is 0. This is minus M. This is minus M. What is S1 is 0. X1 is my 2. This is 4. So how you find this? So if I just find this value, so 0 multiply 0 plus 2 multiply 1 plus 4 multiply 0 minus upper value. So what is that? This is 0. Also, since this is the identity matrix, so it will always be a 0. So look at that, this value, how you find this value is, so 0 multiply 3 by 4, 0, 2 multiply minus 1 by 2 is minus 1, 4 multiply this, so it's a plus 1, minus of the upper value, so again it's a 0. Okay. And similarly, you can find the other value. Look at the last value is 2 multiply 0, 4, so 0 plus 4 plus 48, so it's my 52, and this value you can easily compute it as M and M. So look at that. Now check whether this is optimal or, so this is the part 1, you have to complete it, you have to construct the table with this BFS. Now check whether this is optimal or not. So this is optimal, because all are greater than 0, so that's the required answer. If it is not optimal, then you can find the entering variable and the leaving variable. Okay, so by this method you can also check your all your answer which you have computed by simplex, big M or any of the previous videos. So let's look at the one more example so you can easily understand. So consider this LPP. You have to formulate the simplex table by consider this as the starting BFS. And again, you have to check whether this is optimal or not. So you can write the standard form here. So what's the target is, you have to construct the table by taking S1 and X1 as the starting BFS. So always remember, the first one is written here, second one is here. So since S1 and X1 are the starting BFS, so the column corresponding to S1 and S1 form the identity matrix, and ZJ minus CJ is our 0. Okay, then you have to formulate the B. B is nothing but the column corresponding to this. What is the column corresponding to S1? Column corresponding to the X1. So column corresponding to X1 is 1, 0. Look at that. And column corresponding to X1 is 1 and 2. Based on this, you can find the B inverse. So if you start from here, what is the starting variables are there? So S1 and S2. So it means this is the column corresponding to S1. This is the column corresponding to S2. So this is minus 1 by 2. This is plus 1 by 2. So it means now there is only need to find the column corresponding to X2, B inverse of A2. This is B inverse of A3, column corresponding to this, and so on. So you need to find the three columns. So column corresponding to X2 is B inverse, multiply with the column corresponding to X2. So this is the column corresponding to 2, 4. Column corresponding to X3, B inverse of 2, 3. Column corresponding to the right hand side, 10, 15. Okay, so substitute the value of B inverse here. So once you solve it, you will get 0, 2 column corresponding to x2. This is 1 by 2, 3 by 2, and the right hand side is 5 by 2, 15 by 2. Okay, now the only remaining is you have to find this ZJ minus CJB. So this is already knows that. So what is the value of x? This is 3, this is 2, this is minus 2, this is 0, this is 0. S1 is my 0, x1 is my 3. So only need to find these four values. So look at that, this value 0 multiply 0 is 0 plus 6 minus of the upper value. So that's my 4. Similarly, you can find the other values. Now check whether this is optimal or not. Again, this is optimal. So this means if it is not optimal, then you, again you can find their entering variables. So look at one more example so that you can easily clear the concept. So solve this LPP by starting this as my BFS. So write the standard form here. Now you have to formulate the LPP in which this as my starting BFS. So x2, firstly x2, so this is there. Similarly x3, so this x3 is the second column of the identity matrix. X1 is here. Okay, so this is there, and the ZJ minus CJ corresponding to this is 0. Based on this, you can formulate the identity B matrix, that is called as the basic matrix. First column is x2. What is the column corresponding to x2 is 3, 2 and 2. So the 3, 2 and 2. So this is the x2 column, this is x3 column, this is x1 column. Based on this, you can find the B inverse. So if this is LPP, if you start with them, from where you start that? This is S1, S2 and S3. So it means this is the column corresponding to S1. This is column corresponding to S2 and this is column corresponding to S3. So you can substitute the value here. Look at that. So the only column which are left behind is column corresponding to the right hand side. So how you find the column corresponding to right hand side is B inverse of right hand side value. Okay. So after multiply you will get this. So this value is nothing but 50 by 41 and so on. Okay. Now the only left is ZJ minus CJ. So what is the column corresponding to here is 3, this is 5, this is 4, this is 0, 0, 0. What is that? This is my 5, this is x3, 4, x1 is 3. Now the remaining one is, you can how to find that? 5 multiply by this, minus 75 by 41, 4 multiply by this, 24 by 41, 3 multiply by this, minus 6 by 41, minus of the upper value. Okay. So once you get this, so what we'll do, you will calculate this value as of here. Sorry, this value is negative is there. Okay, and so on. So if this is optimal, then you can, stop the process. Otherwise, you can find the entering and the leaving variable. So if this is the value, okay, if this is the value, so you can say this is optimal. Then you have to stop the process, otherwise you can move to the entering and the leaving variable. So I hope you can still learn this method. Based on this method, you can easily check your previous all those questions. Till then, you can subscribe the channel for the more update videos on the optimization techniques and the other. So till then, best of luck students, make more practice.